For you are the reason why we lift our heads, why we lift our voice, why we sing to you. You are the reason we're alive today. We are here to sing. It's all because of you. And you are the reason why we lift our heads, why we lift our voice, why we sing to you. And you are the reason we're alive today. We are here to say it's all because of you. Tell them you are the reason.
You are the reason.
Oh,
you are the reason.
You are the reason.
You are the reason.
Oh, you are
the reason. You are the reason.
You are the reason.
You are the reason.
You are the reason.
You are the reason. Everything within about you is great.
Matchless love and beauty, endless words. Nothing in this world can satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry. Father, your presence is heaven. Your presence is heaven to me. So we're singing, oh Jesus, oh Jesus. Your presence is sing, oh
Jesus.
Your
presence is heaven.
Cry out, oh say,
we are standing.
We are standing.
is watching. Hey, I spoke to her. She's like, oh, I get you all the time. I said, you do? She says, yes, ma'am. I said, my cock to her. Amen. So, hi, Rebecca. Praise God. And everyone that's watching from India and all over, wherever you're watching, welcome, welcome. And, of course, the ones in here, welcome, welcome. Katie Ann, it's good to see you. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Yeah, I've been out for a while, but we still love you. Just didn't see you. Amen. Praise the Lord. And, of course, your sister. Good to see you all. Good to see you all. Amen. Ryan, good to see you. Good to see you. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Dr. Elizabeth, good to see you. I know you was out fucker. You know. She was putting her head this way. Good to see you. And Shireen, you traveled all the way. Where's Shireen? You traveled all the way to Jamaica and God brought you back safely. Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Good to see you all. Glory to God. And yes, good to see you, man. It's been a while. Praise the Lord. It's good to see you. Welcome. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Somebody say testimony. All right. All right. We overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Amen. 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 It's great. Oh, I forgot to bring my testimony. I wanted to give it a few weeks ago, and I didn't get a chance to, and I forgot to bring it. But, you know, I can describe it. Amen. I can do that. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. First testimony up is Sister Linda. Where is she? Sister Linda. Welcome. Welcome. And give your testimony. You need a micro. Yes. And then face the camera. No, come to the front and then face this way. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Lord Church.
Praise the Lord.
Aren't you glad God loved you so much that he didn't leave you where you was at? I've come to know him as Jehovah Gabor, the God that fights for me. I've came to know him as Jehovah Mapalti, the God that delivered me. And I came to know him as Jehovah Rapha, the God that healed me. My testimony is a testimony of forgiveness, and God avenged me. On December the 3rd of 2018, the thing I feared the most happened to me. I lost my only child due to gun violence. Somebody decided that my child's life wasn't worth living, and so they robbed him and his friend. They shot both of them execution style. Shot my son first because my son wasn't even supposed to be there. It was for the guy that my son was with. So I say this to you young folks. Be careful who you are around. Be careful who you associate yourself with. My son grew up with this boy, and me, my mother, and my sister, we would always tell him, we would say, Ma, we don't want you hanging with him. Sometimes you can't see things when you're in it. You can't see it. So when people are on the outside looking in can see it, when they tell you, you become rebellious. You like, no. So this particular day, I was supposed to go to work. It was on a Monday, and I seen my son for the very last time. 9 o'clock that night, that Monday night, I was getting a phone call, not from the detectives, but from my mother, who asked me, was my son in the house? I said, no. She said, well, I just got word that he got shot. And I said, he got shot? And then she said, yeah, he supposed to have gotten shot in the head. I knew right then and there she wasn't playing. I broke down. I started crying. In the mix of all that, I said, God, I know I'm probably wrong for saying this, but I want the mother of whoever killed my child to feel the same pain that I feel. I want the mother of the person who killed my child to have to stand over her child's lifeless body and grieve like I had to grieve and put her child in the ground, like I had to put my child in the ground. You gotta watch, be careful what you say. Be careful what you say. Because the guy killed my son on December the 3rd. buried my son on December the 13th. December the 14th, I was sitting down watching the news. I seen when the news came on, the young man was killed, shot multiple times. Did not know that this was the young man that killed my son. I cried. I wept for this young man. I wept. I didn't even know it was him, but I'm crying because now I'm like, oh, this mother got to go through the same thing I'm going through. Remember, I just said when it's a mix, I wanted your, you know. So you gotta be careful. But I had to go back and repent. I had to go back and repent, and I had to ask God to forgive me for what I said. But even in the mix of that, God avenged me, because God, cut, snuff, you know, a lot. You live by the sword, you die by the sword, pretty much. So we buried my son. Then God started to deal with me, because in the midst of when this happened, I was in a backsliding state. I thank God he's married to the backslider. I thank God that he is close to those who have a broken heart and a contrite spirit, because God did a work in me. He opened my eyes to see some things. And I had to, how do you forgive a person that you will never ever hear them say, I'm sorry for what I've done to you. I'm sorry for how I altered your life. I'm sorry for, you know, changing the life of your grandson, because now he got to grow up without a father. And he's in a household with a whole bunch of females. And now you're seeing stuff. Y'all know, some of y'all know what I'm talking about, whose sons are raised up in a household with a whole bunch of females. You know those sons, those boys start taking on female tendencies. And now you're seeing this. What the young man didn't realize was that he altered my grandson's life as well. So God said, you're going to have to forgive. You're going to have to forgive him in order for me to deal with your hurt and your pain. And when I made up my mind to forgive, God started dealing with me. Things started falling in place in the midst of me praying. Because remember, I told you I was in a backsliding state. I was doing anything I thought I was big and bad enough to do. I don't know, you know, about y'all, but I'm going to keep this all the way 100. I was fornicating. I was doing whatever I wanted to do. I was posting half stuff, pictures on Facebook, not revealing, but being a seductress. Being a seductress. And I was doing that, operating in the Jezebel spirit. Yes, and I had to be delivered of those things. In the midst of me being in outside of the realm of God, I broke the hedge of protection. I ended up catching COVID. I never forget Pastor Sam, he called me. He said, yeah, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you should know evil. I didn't know that this man knew that I was around death. Person on the left died. Person on the right died. They came and got me late at night, because you know when you got COVID and you in the hospital, they don't want to be bothered with you. You know, they don't come and get you to do MRIs 12 and 11 and 12 o'clock at night. They come and get me 11 o'clock and 12, 11, something, almost 12 o'clock, midnight. Dead bodies. How in the world Pastor Sam knew? He said, yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death. But see, this is what happened when you step outside of the realms of God and you think you big and bad enough to do what you want to do. Because he will humble you. And you have to go back and get on your knees and say, God, forgive me. I say, God, forgive me for everything that I have done. If you can deliver me, God, you can have the rest of me. And I will lift up my voice and proclaim and tell sinners your ways and tell them that it ain't worth it. Because at the end of the day, we have a God that we have to answer to. And God, you can use whatever bit of me that you have left. Am I saying that I'm out of everything? No. In some things, it's a process, but some things he did a quick work, and he's still working on me. But I came to know God in all of that as my avenger and the one who healed me and the one who fought for me, because I did not know that this young man had killed my son. I didn't know. And God said, well, who are you really mad with? And I'm about to finish it up. He said, who are you really mad with? Are you mad with the boy or are you mad at the devil? Because I loved him too. he didn't get a chance to repent. He didn't get a chance to come and hear about Jesus. I love him too. I said, my God. I said, Lord, I'm sorry. Because now that mother got to go through the same pain. She has to go through the same thing that I had to go through. And I got an opportunity to meet the mother. And we hugged and I said, I forgive you. I said, because you a mother just like I am. And I don't know, you know, if you was telling your son the same thing I was telling mine. Don't do this. Don't do that. Stay away from this one. Stay away from that one. You know, I don't know. And I told her, I forgive you. And I came to peace with the death of my son. And that's how I was able to forgive the young man. And it grieves me so because he never got a chance to hear about Jesus. He never got a chance to repent because prior to him killing my son, he killed two more people in a house fire. The city, they had him in custody, but because they said they didn't have enough evidence, they let him go. When you slap your children on the wrist for little small things, you better watch out. Because when you don't deal with the small things, it becomes bigger. If the state would have kept him in custody, he would not have had a chance to take two more lives. We must forgive, even when you will never get an apology, even when you will never hear the person say, I'm sorry. You must forgive. Don't hold any resentment. Don't hold no anger. Don't be bitter. Don't hold no animosity. Let it go, because it will eat you like cancer. Let it go. Give it to God. Don't make peace with it. Let it go. Let it go. And now I'm able to sleep good at night because I'm at peace. I'm at peace.
Y'all, I need a few people who to stand to their feet. I need a few people who believe in forgiveness, the power in forgiveness, the power in forgiveness, to say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I hear y'all. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let it go. Thank you. Maybe seated. And it's so powerful. Sometimes people say, well, I've made peace with this. Don't make peace with it. Let it go. Amen. 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 Wow, very, very powerful. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. Glory to God. Amen. Next up is Sister Camille. Praise the Lord. Right here. You got testimony? I just found out this song. No, she got a big something.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Good night, saints. Today, I'm Johnny coming. Hi, Dad. Good night, everybody. October 10th, John had an accident, a serious accident, with my car. And the bad thing about it, I did not have full coverage on my car. I only had liability. They took about 2 days to total the car. It was bad. But because I didn't have full coverage, the guy that was a four-car accident.
The what?
Four-car.
Oh.
Car accident. The guy that caused the accident, he had no insurance.
Mercy.
Absolutely none. So I was messed up. Was a total loss for me. They even sent me a letter in the mail on October 14th saying that there's nothing they can do. The car is gone. I have no money. I've lost everything. Basically, the total loss for me financially as well. We just got a car in December. I
do not like paying a monthly payment for it. The Toyota Corolla was paid off. Sunday during service, when they were talking to John, first of all, Dad rebuked something in me, and I felt good afterwards. I know something happened. So please, don't take it personal when Dad rebukes. It's not you he's rebuking. It is something in you. Because what I told Mom is that I wasn't feeling well for almost 3 weeks. I was just pushing to come to work, pushing to come to church. Dad rebuke?
Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Dad.
Something left, and I've been feeling good since then. But Monday, I sat at home. I said, Lord, I'm a tither, I'm a giver. I got to try again. And going backwards a little bit, I had the title. Couldn't find it. All of a sudden, I couldn't find the title. I had to get a copy of the title from NV. So it took them about 2 weeks. It's at a mechanic shop. We told him to just take it and do whatever he wants to do with it. It's a total loss. So in order to reimburse him, we said, do whatever you want with it. John dropped off the title on Saturday. Tuesday morning now, I called to cancel my insurance with GEICO. And I told them I was kind of disappointed that there was nothing they can do for me. But this young lady that I was talking to, I just told her, is there anything you can do, anything, even to tap into my uninsured motorist insurance? 20 minutes later, she called me and she told me that they approved $25,000. $25,000. That's not the only thing.
Talk to me and tell me God ain't good. From no coverage to $25,000. Come on, talk.
$25,000. The $25,000, mind you, my car is 8 years old. When I bought it, it was $10,000 8 years ago.
You want to tell the rest?
Yeah, go ahead and tell the rest.
My car value was higher. So what they're paying me is almost $2,000, about $13,000, almost $12,000 for my car. So it didn't lose any value. I'm not losing anything for my car. Yeah.
Yeah. Bought the car for $10,000.
Had an
accident.
Got back $12,000.
The Lord is down.
But mind you, when I had the accident, I told Dad, I told Mom, they were like, Lord Jesus. But they're going to touch and agree. We're going to pray for favor that God is going to do something. And I remember the word came from Mom, and she said, God going to do something that he don't usually do for this situation. And a little bit, we got a little wary, you know, we got a little wary and a little discouraged and stuff. But he did come through. We are paying nothing out of pocket. I collect my check on Monday.
Come on, y'all better get y'all better know it. That is nothing but a miracle. That is a miracle. That is a miracle. That is amazing. Oh my God. Oh my God. I've been driving since I was 16. Many cars. And I've never, ever, ever, ever heard of anything like this before. This is only God. Can I get an amen? Can I get a thank you, Jesus? Can I get a Lord, the Lord is good? Praise God. Praise God. Woo! Yeah, that's right. The Lord is good to me. Okay, well, if y'all ain't believing, the Lord is good to me, so I'm going to leave y'all alone. Amen. Hey, a real good one. All righty. That's oh my God. All right. Let us welcome Sister Irma.
Amen, everybody. I got two testimonies.
All righty.
So basically, the first testimony is when Pastor Vincent came the other day, and he said, the lady in blue, you know, the things of the Spirit. So I was like, yeah, I love the things of the Spirit. Yeah, I want to be in the things of the Spirit all the time. I love God so much. I want to do so much things in the Spirit. I want to know the Spirit more than, you know, like the norm. So when I went home and he said, you're going to have an encounter. So I went home. It wasn't at 12. It was at 3. Right on the nose, 3 o'clock. All of a sudden, I felt the presence of the Lord around me. I started coughing. Then I started burping. All this stuff started happening. You know, when you got things coming out, you know what I mean? So there was some stuff that was happening. After all of that started happening, I started singing. And as I started singing, I was singing the songs that I like. All of a sudden, I started hearing the songs that he wanted me to sing. Amen. And at one time, I used to hear, like, I think I heard it one time, Angels. We was on the praise team. We was in the hotel, and I thought it was Reggie. And we looked around, and we didn't see Brother Reggie. We was, like, trying to figure out what was singing. So I heard the singing, but even as I heard the singing, I was so happy with the Lord. As I heard the singing, I said, yes, Lord, this is what I want. I want to hear the things of heaven. I want to hear the things in the Spirit. You know what I mean? More than anything. So as I was hearing that, I also was hearing like somebody was praying. As the song was going, I was also hearing, you know, the thing, like somebody praying in tongues. And I was just happy about it. So I thank God for that one. And I was just happy. I was like, thank you, Lord, for giving me this tonight. So I'm just grateful. So the next testimony is that I came to Dad. I was going through some things, and I kept saying, Dad, I can't find a job. I can't find a job. Dad kept praying. He kept praying. Every single time I got the job, somebody would take the job. So I was like, what's going on? So I think this was like the third or the fourth job that this was happening. So I went on an interview, went to the interview. As I went to the interview, nobody came downstairs to meet me. So I was like, it has to be something wrong. So I called Dad again. And I was like, "That." He said, they're going to call you back. They're going to call you back. So that next morning, they called back. I was just so happy. I was like, okay. They called me back on the interview. I got an orientation tomorrow. Yes. Yes. Amen. Amen. I'm so happy. I got the job. I got the job. I got the job.
God is good. God is good. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh my God. Powerful, powerful, powerful. What a mighty God we serve. Amen. Amen. Now we're going to welcome Brother Ryan. All right. Woo, woo, woo. Praise the Lord. Amen.
So, this testimony is like a story, and it's kind of like an account. So, it's good to be home.
It is good to be, and welcome home.
Thank you. So, that's what this is an account of what the steps I had to go through was. And it's like, okay, I had this dream like 2 or 3 months ago. Mm-hmm. Was walking in my neighborhood, and like this man just came up to me and just started praying for me, and it was like the fire came down on me and like burnt off a lot of the bad stuff that was attempting to stay on me, or get on me, mm-hmm. And it was just burnt that off, and then part of the dream had to do with evangelism, mm-hmm. And so. In, I guess I have to say, in my limited understanding, I framed that as I have to, like, jump over here. So, long story short is I did meet with those people and do the evangelism. But I was over there for, like maybe 3 to 5 weeks. Mm-hmm. Just with these brethren. They prayed for me. They prophesied. We went out. We did street evangelism. We witnessed to people, preached to people, and just prayed with people. So that was good, and that took place. But it got to where I just had to reach out to Pastor Sam and say, Pastor Sam, like you guys are home to me, and like it hasn't been easy without you is the words I used. And so I reflect on this verse where Paul wrote to Timothy and said, "You have many teachers and many guides, but you don't have many fathers." So, Pastor Sam is that to me. I can't say that about many people, and I don't say that about many people. Very few people would I ever say that. Pastor Sam is a spiritual father to me. So, anyway. So amen. I just wanted to give that account, and the result is I'm just blessed.
Y'all better stand to your feet. Y'all better stand to the feet, to your feet, and recognize the house that you're in. Recognize the house. Amen. 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 Glory to God. Amen. My. Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Don't have me. Praise God. Amen. All right, the next person is Sister Raquel. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hello. Hello, everyone. I've known Mom and Dad for how many years now? So my testimony is, I remember one year I was living in Georgia, and I called Mom. It was like, I think early morning, maybe like 8:39 on a Monday. And I told her, I said, "Mom, I just got kidnapped by somebody." I was walking actually to a store. The person came, like, you know how you kind of like turn right into like a maybe. Hello? Okay. So I was walking left, and they cut me off. And I happened to, in that moment, I just got stuck. Like, Lord, what do I do? Where do I go? He literally picked me up off the ground, threw me over his shoulder, put me on the side of the passenger side of the car. And he had like a little handgun and said, "Get to the back of the car." And one thing that I remember that my mother always told me was, if something like that happens, excuse my French, but you fight like hell. And I remember calling Mom, and she said, when I got to a store, I called Mom, and I was like, "Mom, somebody just kidnapped me." Because that was for me running. I had one flip-flop on, Jesus. The other one was still in the car. And Mom was like, "You have to call 911. You have to call 911. And when I did, do you know that they did not believe me? They thought I was just making something up in my head. I was like, "Mom, they're telling me if I don't tell the truth, then I'm going to go to jail." I'm like, "Mom, I've never been to jail before. What am I going to do?" She was like, hold on. "I'm about to call some people I know," or whatever. And I've also been in the world. I've dibbled and dabbled with women and men. Mom knows that. Dad knows it too. And I remember when I first met them, Mom actually, what was it? You see me walking or something? Was it that you seen me walking? It was by the Ramada Inn. And yeah, she seen me walking. She was like, "What you doing out here?" I'm like, "Nothing." She was like, "Oh no, you out here. What are you doing? You're so young. What are you doing?" I'm like, "Nothing. I was staying with a friend. I was over here. I was over there." She's like, "Well, I know some people. I'm going to have them take you in." And it was Minister Steph and Jason. And I thank y'all. Because so many times the devil wanted to take me out. Just for me living my lifestyle, just for me doing whatever. But I thank God that I know one of it is God saved me by giving me my daughter. And even though my daughter didn't come from marriage, but I know God used her to save me. And it was mom's prayers every day. I'll never forget, it was one time I was hanging out with friends. It might have been like 3 o'clock. 3 o'clock in the morning. I blew mom's phone up. I was intoxicated, but I was poisoned by the intoxication. And I called mom. She didn't answer. I kept calling. Finally, she answered. She was like, "What you doing?" I'm like, "Mom, I'm so sick, Mom. Mom, I'm so sick, Mom. I can't even hardly stand up. Mom, I'm sick, I'm sick, I'm sick." She started praying. You know what mom do when she get into that deep prayer, she does whoo. And I was just like, and I started vomiting. She stayed on the phone with me till everything came up. By that time, I was so weak. My body was so weak. Mom was like, "Nope." It's almost like God showed her exactly where I was, because I was hurled over the toilet. She was like, "Raquel, can you get up?" I'm like, "No, Mom, I can't." She kept praying. I was like, "Mom, I don't feel right. I feel like I'm about to pass out." She was just like, "Stand up now." And I stood up, and it was by the grace of God, because I felt like I wanted to faint. And it almost felt like my spirit was ready to leave. And then she was just like, and I didn't know. I didn't go to the doctor. It was mom's prayers. But you know, I love mom so much, because she don't know how much of a blessing she is. Like, I truly look at mom and dad like my parents, because they prayed for me over and over again. Minister Stephanie and Jason, they could have put me out, but they didn't. They did not put me out. There was times they were like, she'd be like, "Where are you going?" "I'll be back. I'm just going to the store." 5 minutes later, mom's calling me. "Where are you?" I'm like, "Jesus, what are you doing?" And she was like, "Raquel, you know you can't lie to me." I was like, "Okay, mom, I'll just run over there and blah, 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 blah." She was just like, "Go back to the house." I'm like, "Okay." And I truly just thank Steph, because Minister Steph, because at one point in time, she was my representative payee at the time. You remember that? And there was times like, "Steph, can I just get some money? I just want to go. She was like, "Uh-uh, I'm only giving you so much money, because you ain't about to go spend it over here and over there." Sometimes she act like mom. I'd be like, "Oh, okay." But I just want to say, mom and dad, I thank y'all so much. I thank y'all, because it's y'all praise that kept me here. I'm still here. People don't make it till 35, and I'm 35 today. I met them when I was 17 years old. Yeah, I met them when I was 17. I remember Diamond and Sam when they was little.
Yes.
Woo, thank you. But yeah, I just truly thank y'all. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
God bless you. God bless you. Come on now. Come on now. From the age of 16, she's been through some things. She's been through some stuff. And she made it open. She said, I've done some things that I ain't got no business doing. I've been with some people that I ain't got no business been with. But in spite of it all, glory to God, we never given up on her. We never gave up on her. We never gave up on her. We never said, you will never amount to nothing. Instead, every time we say, come, you can do this. Come, you can do this. Amen. God is so great. Let me see it, man. I tell you, I thought she was going to give this one too, but amazingly, it was, I think it was after the intoxicate one. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to have to get this girl, because now she's in whatever state. I said, I'm going to have to get this girl out of there. I said, no, where's Sister Ann? Where's Sister Ann? Outside. I said, Sister Ann, can you do me a favor? She said, what, Pastor Marshall? I said, if I pay you, give you gas you up, and just give you some pocket money shit in case you want to buy anything, can you go drive 6 hours and go pick up this girl for me? And she says, sure, Pastor Marshall. So she got in the car. I gave her the money, cash, filled the tank, here's some pocket money, go get her. When she got there, ring the door, ding dong. She said, I changed my mind, and I'm going to stay here. True story. She said, I changed my mind. I'm going to stay here. But you're not doing good. She said, but I think I just need to stay here for a little while longer. I said, but what are you doing? She said, but I just think I need to stay here for a little while longer. And we talked. And then Sister Ann just got up and said, Sister Ann, go ahead and leave. And she left. I don't remember if she spent the night in a hotel. It's been a few years ago. But she finally came home and I left her alone. Amen. So she's been through some stuff, but she's still standing, and it's only by the grace of God. Can I get an amen from somebody? It's only by the grace of God. Amen. Amen. And last but not least, did Sister Ann have a testimony? Not tonight. Okay. All righty. And last but not least, Sister Roxanne. Amen.
Hello? Amen. I'm not going to be long, but I just want to give God thanks and give him praise, even in the little things, not as an insignificant, but even in those little situations, he shows up. A couple of weeks ago, I was here and I told you a testimony about my situation with the car, towing and everything, and how the lady worked it out for me to get my car all the way up to Baltimore, and I didn't have to pay out of pocket. Well, the Lord showed up again with the same company. This time, the tire was flat. So the guy came and he said, you have a spare? I said, no, I don't have a spare. He said, okay, I'll see what I can do. So he said, I'm really not supposed to do this, but it had a nail in the tire. It was a nail in the tire. So he said, I'm not supposed to do this, but, and I didn't ask him. He just said, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a plug in it for you. And he's not supposed to do that. So the Lord caused him to break the rules for me. Amen. But that's not the end of the story. I went back in. And so I went back out just to see how things were going. So I'm just, you know, looking around the car. I noticed a piece of metal in the other tire. But you couldn't really tell unless you looked very close, because the nail of the head of the nail was gone, but the piece of the nail was still stuck in it. I thought it was a pebble, but it was not. I couldn't pull it out. So I said, I have a nail here. Can you do this one? He said, yeah, sure. I'll do it for you. So that's the testimony. God calls, and it's, I just have to give God thanks, because I remember years ago the Lord said that he will cause people and companies to break their very own rules just to bless us. So I thank you, God, for allowing these people to break every rule that they have in order for me to be blessed. Amen.
And amen, amen, amen. Break the rule of AAA, my Lord Jesus. Oh, glory to God. And in addition to that, this young man got blessed because he got prayer. You can't forget prayer. Praise the Lord. He got blessed. He got prayer. And he was told about Jesus. And he said, you know what? I really needed this prayer because I just lost my father. So he said, I really, really needed that. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Amen. That's the power of prayer. He was so, he felt it in his, just in his heart. Amen. Amen. Sister Pam, got a quick one for us. Okay. Amen. Amen. I thought she didn't have one, but she got a quick one for us.
Thank you. There are two quick ones. I'm sorry. Okay. Got to give me.
All right. I need for you to be right here.
Okay. Real quick.
Right here. Yeah.
This close?
Yeah.
Closer?
I look. Turn. Face the camera.
Oh, right there?
Yes. Aunt Pam, we're live.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
First testimony is I lived in New Jersey and I moved to Maryland 2 years ago, and I've been having problems with my taxes because of working in New Jersey, living in Maryland. So I had problems in 22. They wouldn't give me the money because even though my accountant sent paperwork and everything that's saying that I moved down to New Jersey a particular time, and I was in Maryland at this time, and I worked from this time until that time. 22, okay, I'm fighting it again. And then 23, turn around, and they did the same thing again because the company I worked for actually inadvertently filled out my taxes incorrectly.
Oh.
So it caused that the problem with the New Jersey tax station. And we kept going back and forth, sending paperwork. Then I called the company, and I literally, they told me that they would not give me a new W-2 form. They weren't going to do it. They weren't going to help me at all. So I called my tax attorney. I said, they shut me down. They're not going to do anything. So we went through, got all the records again, all my taxes again for 22, 23. We sent it, and it's a substantial amount of money that they owe me because of, it was the New Jersey State. My company it was just wrong. So I've been waiting and I've been praying, and I said, you know, Lord, I said, that's my money.
Right.
That's my money. And they stole it from me. Basically, they stole it from me, but that's my money. So this morning I just got a text from the accountant saying that they're in processing of looking at the paperwork. So I'm praising God and thanking him in advance that now I will receive
everything
that belongs to me.
Every nickel, every dime, every cent,
so
in the name of Jesus.
So that's what I'm praising God for, because we were going back and forth. It's been 2 years, 2 years to the day, 2 years, absolutely. And I've never gave up. I said, God, that's mine. I said, they stole my money. I said, and they lied about it, and then they wouldn't help me. And then I was like, well, you know what? That's all right. So, and then I never gave up. I just said, Lord, I just continue to thank you. And just, I know you're going to work it out. But there is a timing for everything.
Come on.
And I realized that you have to be patient as God is working, because he is working behind the scenes.
That's right. That's
even
right.
Though you don't see it,
that's
he
right.
is working.
That's
and
right.
in the time that he's working, what you need to do is just praise him for it.
That's right.
It's, You know, I stopped. I said, you know what? Okay, when they shut me down, I said, I'm not going to complain anymore. I said, Lord, I'm just going to thank you and praise you that you are working. And at the right time, I will receive what belongs to me.
That's right.
So I just thank God for that. And the second testimony, really quick, is that when I moved down here 2 years ago, the most important thing for me is that when I moved to Maryland, my family's here, which is great, but what's for me is finding a place to worship, because that's the most important part of your life. Yeah. Is that, you know, everything is, the job is good, but where you worship and where you serve God is the most important in your life. And you know, and that was a major one for me, because when I left New Jersey, I kind of had a disconnect with the church I was there. So it was kind of, I got kind of beat up before I even got here. So I was thanking God for a place of worship, you know, where the word is good, where the praise is good, and also the people who truly love God. And I have to actually praise God and thank God for everlasting life. Because once I got here, God began to restore me to the point where I now, the joy came back, the desire came back. Because everything was just shut down because of what I was going through in New Jersey. But God brought me to a place here. And I just want to praise him for this everlasting life. This is a precious house. There are not houses like this anywhere, where the presence of God is so evident, where the word of God is taught, where you have pastors who really love you and pray for you and intercede for you. There's not a man of God like I've seen in Pastor Sam. I love the God in him. I thank God for the God in him. And the God in Pastor Marsha, you don't see this everywhere. And so we have to treasure them. We have to treasure what God has given us, because God brought us to a place here where we're fed, where we're prayed for, where we're looked at, where we're loved. So don't take it lightly. Don't take it for granted. Because where I came from, we didn't have this like this. And this has been so precious. And I am so grateful to God for this house. I am so grateful to God for Pastor Sam and Pastor Marsha. I am so grateful for the word of God. I am so grateful for the presence of God. I am so grateful for all of it. And I bless God for it. I magnify God for it. I extol him for it. He is truly great and gracious. He has taken care of all of us. Every last one of you are here because of God's goodness. Every last one of you are standing here because God brought you here. It is not just because it happened. Yes. It's because God designed for it. You were destined to come here. Yes. Don't take it lightly.
That's right.
Don't take it lightly. Bless God every day for it, because there are a lot of people who wish they were here.
Jesus.
And could join in it and enjoy it. So we have to keep. You just have to treasure it. It is a treasure. We have to treasure them. We have to treasure how they love us. We have to treasure how they care for us. There are not many women of God who care for their sheep like they do. It is a blessing and their treasure. So I want to say thank you.
Oh, God.
I want to say thank you. And I want to say thank you to God.
Amen. You know, on that note, y'all better say, I need to hear some noise. We're going to welcome Pastor Sam. On that note, we're going to welcome Pastor Sam. On that note, amen, 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 amen. I can't hear you. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the true living God. Amen, amen. Hallelujah! I can't hear you! Hallelujah! Blessed be the name of the Lord! Amen!
Hallelujah.
Amen!
Thank you.
He said, bring you into a good land, a dry land flowing with milk and honey. Amen! Amen. Glory to Amen. God.
That was awesome testimony.
Yes.
Amen. Come on, let's clap our hands.
Oh, hallelujah.
Let's bless God for what He is doing.
Yeah.
It deserves all the glory. It deserves all the honor. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. I didn't have enough time for message. So, I liked it. This is good. Everybody's testimony was so powerful. So inspired, encouraging. Amen. Thank you. Awesome. Even, and Pam, thank you. You are preaching, man. That was good. Thank you. We appreciate you too and your family. We love everybody. Amen. You know, our pastoral ministry, if you don't love people, you can't do it well. It's all about the love of God. Amen. When we see how He loves us, we have no choice but to love you the same way He loves us. We serve a good God. We serve an awesome God. Amen. Let me just pray and seal this testimony because the enemy is mad. And he's going to stay mad. The Bible says we overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. What happened here today, the testimony, what happened in the realm of the spirit, it recreate an environment of doing the same miracle. That it did. Amen. Amen. Even Camille testimony was powerful too. From nothing to 25,000. Oh my God. Oh my God. My God, my God. That was something. I know at one point you are saying, man, if I know I should have gotten full coverage, but God changed it around in the realm of the spirit. Even though you don't have it, He give you the money. Even more than full coverage. Our God is good. Our God is an awesome God. Amen. If you don't have your testimony yet, it's coming. I say it's coming. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for all the testimonies that was given today. We thank you because you are the one that have done it. And I thank you for the testimonies that you are even creating in the realm of the spirit. We thank you for those that will come back and give testimony for the goodness of God. And the testimony that have been given today are sealed in the name of Jesus Christ. That there be no counter attack, no retaliations in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the name that is above every name. Father, we give you praise and we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name. Come on, and the church shout, Amen, amen. We're going to take our tithe and offering. Pastor Masha, you want to come take that? Amen, amen. Let's take our tithe and offering. God is being good to us. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Trust me, I always have a word. I have a word. If I start, you won't leave yet till 11 o'clock. Amen. I have a word about to 10. In an envelope. Our ushers will give you one. How was the conference? Prophetic voice conference was powerful. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Everybody were here. I didn't see you for the conference. You have to be here. It was powerful. My goodness. My goodness. They went back. I took them to DC on Monday and Tuesday. They flew back to Trinidad. Amen. They really enjoyed themselves. It was powerful on Sunday. Oh my God. I like that after the preaching and the teaching, the marching around was powerful. The ministration, prophetic ministration was good. Amen. You guys received the prophetic word. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. You receive it. Amen. Any confirmation? Is it word of knowledge or word of wisdom? Amen. A lot of word of wisdom, right? A lot of word of knowledge. Do you know the difference between word of wisdom and word of knowledge? Who knows? I had the tip prophetic here. There's word of knowledge and there's word of wisdom. Word of knowledge means past and present. When a prophetic word is given, they will tell you of your past or of your now. We also call it revealed knowledge. That means now. You know, word of knowledge is past and present. And word of wisdom is what? Future. God is saying what is about to do for you. Amen? One thing you need to know about word of wisdom is that when God gives us word of wisdom, is telling us his will for us. Some few happens automatically, just happen. But some most word of wisdom are conditional. Has to do with your obedience. To remain in the path that God has put you, he will do this. Amen. Sometimes there are conditions attached to the promise. Amen? Amen. So, whatever word of wisdom you receive, continue to serve God, is contingent upon you continue to serve God, continue to be obedient. Amen? To God. To God instruction. To God direction. Amen? It's very important because I've seen some people receive word of wisdom, but it didn't come to pass. Yes. If you disobey, it won't come to pass. And I pray that you will obey. I pray you will continue to obey. Amen. Word of wisdom is so powerful because really, how we know a prophet is true word of wisdom. The Bible says, you will know that a prophet is in your midst when their word will come to pass. Amen? When their word will come to pass. Amen? So some word of wisdom, you have to obey God. Some word of wisdom, they are instructions. Amen? So anytime more prophet will come, gonna bring more people here, make sure you record it. Now, does everybody have a phone, right? Amen. Go study and know where your record button. Boom. Record honest. It's very important. Because it's God speaking to you. God telling you his will for you, his purpose for you. Amen. In those prophecies, there are conditions. I know a lot of people don't focus on the condition. They just want to hear that breakthrough when the day is coming. How big is going to be? Amen. It's good too. But focus on the condition. Focus, listen to what God is saying. Amen. Everybody have an iPhone or Samsung. They call it smart phone. Sometimes those things are questioning they're smart. Then sometimes they do something like, are you smart? I think if you have smartphone from that on, when a prophetic one pass on a prophetic word, please record it. Then what you do, when you record it, go home and listen for it over and over and over and over. What it will be, do it will be part of you, you begin to believe it. Giving prophetic words to some people before they didn't believe it. They say, yeah, right. But record it. Go listen to it. And listen to it. It build up your faith to know what God wants to do for you. Amen. Also remember, December 22nd, we're going to have Christmas service here, and then we're going to have Christmas celebration. Amen. Do we get the oil yet? The oil is sealed. Savage, right? In between Laura and Columbia. It's kind of the big oil that we're going to be using December 22nd. If you don't travel, make sure you are in the house. Bring your friends and family. We want to give back. Amen. Just to eat, fun, fellowship, celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And then December 28th, we have Prophetess Kelly will be with us for 3 days. 3 days. He's going to be powerful. We're going to finish 2024 very strong. Amen. 29 is on a Sunday. She'll be with us. She'll be speaking the Sunday morning. She'll be speaking Monday. And Tuesday is crossover service. Crossover service. New Year's Eve. And so it's going to be powerful. So let's get ready. Amen. How many ready for 2025? How many is not ready? How many don't know? How many are excited? Amen. 2025 will be a year of magnanimous grace. Magnanimous grace. We're going to need to operate in that grace of God. Amen? Amen. Where to give is on the screen. Glory to God. Everlasting Life CC. Dollar sign. Cash App. If that is convenient for you, you can give. Dollar sign. Everlasting Life CC. That's Cash App. Also, we have our website. Oh, I'm so excited. Our app is coming. Whoa. Glory to God. Our hub is coming. As a matter of fact, it's ready. But we'll let you know when Minister Sean and Minister Stephanie will come and present it to the church. Amen. First of all, you know, I'm going to see it first with the leaders, go over it. And it's very good. You can do everything there. And you can give through the website. Amen. It's very good. Our church events will be there. Even the event for next year is ready. We're going to put it there so you can see church events. You know, it's going to be good. We will let you know when we will present. Website, also PayPal and Zelle is the same email address. It's finance@everlastinglife.org. finance@everlastinglife.org. Also, I want to thank you for this past weekend. A lot of people, not 3 days, people gave. A lot of people came. Amen. God bless you. I will do that also on Sunday. The attendance was good, right? Attendance was off the chart. It was good. Sunday, this place was full. Man, we thank God for that. Let's continue to be faithful to the church. So I thank God for you for coming, for your time. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And giving as well. I pray that the Lord will bless you exceedingly and abundantly in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I pray that the Lord will change your season, your cycle of struggle to the cycle of blessing. In the mighty name of Jesus, pray that God will break that cycle of not enough or just enough and move you to the cycle of more than enough. In the mighty name of Jesus, because starting from this month, you begin to operate in magnanimous grace. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the ability of God that supersedes your ability. In the name of Jesus Christ, that supersedes your intellect, your supersedes your ability, that supersedes your knowledge. You will operate in it in the mighty name of Jesus, because 2025, we're going to do big stuff. Hallelujah. Grace stuff. Glory to God. And we need the grace of God. We need the push of God. We need divine acceleration. in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So shall it be. I say, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. I say, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. I say, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. I say, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. You will be unstoppable in the name, because you are not alone. Mighty God is with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. Hallelujah. Also, December 7th, right? That's time we're praying. It's going to be a breakthrough prayer. Hallelujah. Breakthrough prayer. We're going to gather some spiritual forces that will break us through 2025. We're going to break to 2025 with strength, with blessing, with grace, with the favor of God. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. It's going to be spiritual breakthrough, financial breakthrough. That prayer will be powerful. You don't want to miss it. Amen. It's going to be also deliverance and remove some stuff and pray some stuff, possess some stuff, receive some stuff, break some stuff that been stopping us, that been challenging. It's going to be on. Hallelujah. It's on a Saturday. Amen. Also, we'll be fasting. Can somebody get excited now? When you talk fasting, everybody's quiet. We will be fasting. Can I hear amen? As we always give you, you know, option, but 3 days straight, if you can do that, if you can do that, you can do 3 days, water, no food. If you cannot, you break in the evening at 6. Please, if you cannot, break at 6. But if you can't, do it. If you can't, don't break at 6. I know who can. Especially the prayer warrior. Let me see your hand, the prayer team. Everybody on the prayer team should do 3 days. A louder amen now. Yeah, 3 days, no food. I text somebody during the prayer, I text them to do 3 days, no food. The person text me back. He said, death! He said that. He said, no, I'm not trying to kill you. I'm trying to So, if you cannot do 3 days, break at what time? 6. Amen? And be here. Amen? And if you cannot fast at all, if you say you are taking medication, talk to your doctor. If the doctor say you cannot because of the strength of your medication. It can happen. Because of your strength or your medication, you have to eat to take your medication. Eat, take your medication, and be here too. God will do what he's going to do. Amen. Some people are like that. If you are taking very strong medication, and I know who are taking medication, so if you don't fast, I know. I know. I know. All these young folks, you're not taking no medication. Make sure you fast. Can I hear amen to that? But the key is be here as well. Even though you eat and take your medication, December 7th, at what time? Is it 12? 12. Please be here. It's going to be powerful. It's to get us ready for what God has for us in 2025. It's going to be on. It's going to be powerful. So we want you to come here and pray. Amen? Yes. Even though take medication, be here. But I would love for everybody at least to do some kind of fast. Amen? And be here, and we are going to pray. Wait to give. Do you have it? Are we ready? Amen. Let us stand. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for the giving and receiving. Because no one gives and does not receive. As they come and to give and to sow or invest in the kingdom of God, I pray that they will get a return. I pray that they will reap in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, bless their seed, bless their tithe and their offering in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And give them return. Give them reward. Bless them exceedingly because they are supporting your kingdom on earth. Father, thank you and I bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.